Okay, let's go for a little test drive. So the 5-speed transmission, a little strange, similar to a Porsche, they call it a dogleg, so reverse is up and to the left where first would normally be. First is back here, so you've got to get a little used to that first to second move, which is different than most cars. Again, my 914 has that same dogleg. AC to low. So when I first bought this car, I was surprised at the revs and how comfortable the car was at higher RPMs. It does redline at 7,000 RPMs. It is the 32 valve version, the higher juice engine that they put in these. The other one was 24 valves. Was 0 to 60 approximately. I don't like revving cars up high, but those were 6,500 RPM redline shifts, so not redline. Off a redline is about 7,100. Pretty smooth. Just a super smooth car with plenty of acceleration. And I'm not knocking the 300 because that engine is silky smooth. Transmission is smooth. One of the easiest shifting, revving cars that I've had is a 5-speed, but it's just going to perform different with the amount of power and the shifts that you have to make. This car is effortless. That was nowhere near lower. See the power of this car. Hopefully from that video you can tell that while they may look the same, and yes, I probably would have or should have gotten a different color, the cars are entirely different. From a drivability perspective, this car is actually more collectible based on the transmission, but again, both are unique in their own ways. Great cars. Thanks for joining me, American Dream Dealer.